हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द न्यू लेक्चर ऑफ आवर लेक्चर सीरीज, ई लेक्चर सीरीज। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द टुडेज लेक्चर, जस्ट हैव द रिकैप ऑफ द प्रीवियस क्लास। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू बाय जंकर्स कैलोरीमीटर, इन विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट जंकर्स कैलोरीमीटर इज स्पेसिफिकली यूज for the determination of calorific value of gaseous fuel and the volatile liquid fuels. In detail, we have learned about the construction of Junkers calorimeter, working of Junkers calorimeter, and the calculation of the calorific value in the Junkers calorimeter. After that, we discussed about the determination of calorific value by Joulong's formula. That's all about the previous class. In today's class, we are going to start with the analysis of coal. This is the new topic. In the analysis of coal, two types of analysis we will discussing: proximate analysis and the ultimate analysis. So let us begin with the analysis of coal. Basically, the analysis of coal may be done in two ways: proximate analysis and the ultimate analysis. The proximate analysis is basically the determination of the moisture content in the coal, volatile matter in percentage in the coal, ash percentage in the coal, and the fixed carbon percentage in the coal. It is called the proximate analysis because the data collected may vary with the procedure adopted for the analysis. That's why it is named as the proximate analysis. It involves determination of the moisture, volatile matter, ash, and the percentage of fixed carbon in the coal sample. While the ultimate analysis is basically the elemental analysis in which various elements in the coal sample will be analyzed. So the ultimate analysis is basically the determination of the carbon percentage, determination of hydrogen percentage, determination of nitrogen, sulfur, and the oxygen percentage in the coal sample. So since various type of elements are being determined in this type of analysis, that's why it is called the ultimate analysis or the elemental analysis. While in the proximate analysis, percentage of moisture, volatile matter, ash, and the fixed carbon are being determined. It is called the proximate analysis because the result obtained in these analysis may vary with the procedure adopted for the analysis. So the word proximate is used in this analysis. So let us start with the proximate analysis. First is the percentage of the moisture content in the coal sample. For the determination of the moisture contents, a known weight of coal sample is taken in an empty crucible. Suppose the weight of the empty crucible is x gram. So in this empty crucible, a known amount of coal sample is taken. So how would you know the amount of coal in the crucible? Just we take the weight of empty crucible. Now put some coal sample in the crucible and take its weight. Suppose it is the y gram. So the difference between x gram and the y gram will be the amount of coal in the crucible. After putting the coal sample in the crucible, put the crucible in oven for an hour at 100 to 110 degree centigrade in the oven. At this temperature, when we heated the sample of coal for an hour, all the moisture get evaporated. After 1 hour, stop the heating and take the crucible from oven and cool it. Then take the weight again. So this time the weight is the z gram. So what is the difference basically between y and z? Y is the crucible weight plus the coal sample weight, while Z is the crucible weight plus the moisture free coal sample weight, because moisture get evaporated already during heating. So now Z gram is the weight of crucible plus weight of moisture free coal. So difference between these two Y grams and the Z gram will be the amount of moisture. So how we calculate the moisture percentage in the coal sample? This is the formula. Moisture percentage is equal to the weight of moisture divided by the weight of coal sample multiplied by 100. So what is the weight of moisture? As we just now discussed, weight of moisture is Y minus Z gram. What is Y? Y is here crucible plus coal sample. And what is Z? Z is the crucible plus the moisture free coal sample. So the difference between these two is the weight of moisture. And weight of coal, what is weight of coal? Y minus X. What is Y minus X? Y is the weight of crucible plus coal, while X is the weight of only crucible. So difference between X and Y is the amount of coal sample. So Y minus X is the weight of coal, while Y minus Z is the weight of moisture. So the total percentage of moisture content will be equal to the Y minus Z, that is the weight of moisture, divided by Y minus X, this is the weight of coal, multiplied by 100. So this is the percentage of moisture content in the coal sample. Very simple procedure it is. I am just again repeating the procedure. For the determination of the moisture content, a known weight of coal sample is taken in the already weighed silica crucible, and the crucible is placed in electric oven at 100-110 degrees centigrade for about an hour. It is then taken out, cooled in desiccator, and weighed again. So this time the weight is the crucible plus the moisture free coal, because during heating all the moisture get evaporated. So by this formula we can calculate the percentage of moisture content in the coal sample. Now second is the determination of the volatile matter percentage in the coal sample. For the determination of the percentage of volatile matter in the coal sample, a known weight of moisture free coal. Now this should be noted that this time we are taking the moisture free coal. So what is the moisture free coal? This coal, after evaporation of the moisture, the remaining coal is the moisture free coal. Now put this moisture free coal in the empty crucible and take its weight. This is the Y grams. Clear? Now this crucible is placed in an electric furnace at 950 degrees centigrade for 7 minutes. During these 7 minutes, at such a high temperature, all the volatile matter get evaporated and the remaining coal is free from volatile matter, and moisture content already evaporated. So this time when we take out the crucible from the electric furnace and cool down and take the weight again, so this Z is the volatile matter free coal. So how would we determine the percentage of volatile matter? The percentage of volatile matter is equal to weight of volatile matter divided by weight of coal sample multiplied by 100. So what is the weight of the volatile matter? It is the Y minus Z. Why it is Y minus Z? Look at here. Y is the weight of crucible plus moisture free coal. Z is the weight of crucible plus volatile matter free coal. So the difference between Z and Y is only the volatile matter. So the weight of volatile matter is equal to Y minus Z grams. And as previous we have discussed, the weight of coal is equal to Y minus X gram. Therefore, the total percentage of volatile matter is equal to Y minus Z divided by Y minus X. This is the weight of coal multiplied by the 100. This is the percentage of volatile matter in the coal sample. So I am again repeating the procedure. For the determination of the percentage of volatile matter, a known weight of moisture-free coal sample is taken in weight crucible. The crucible is placed in an electric furnace at 950 degrees centigrade for about 7 minutes. The crucible is taken out then and cooled in desiccator and weighed again. Suppose this weight, last weight is the Z gram. And the finally we can calculate the volatile matter by this formula. So it is clear to all, I hope it is clear to all of you. Now, the determination of the percentage of ash content in the coal sample. For the determination of the ash content, a known weight of dry coal sample. Dry coal sample means the coal which is free from the moisture, that is the dry coal sample. So this dry coal sample is taken in the weight silica crucible. The crucible is placed in the furnace at around 750 degrees centigrade for half an hour. After this heating at 750 degrees centigrade for half an hour, all the substances removed from the coal and the residue remains only. This residue is the ash. Take the crucible from furnace then and cool it, then take weight again. So this Z is the weight of crucible plus ash only. So percentage of ash content is equal to the weight of ash divided by weight of coal multiplied by 100. So what is the weight of ash content? It is here the Z minus X. Look at here. X is the weight of empty crucible. Z is the weight of crucible plus ash. So, here is only the crucible. While here, crucible plus ash present. So, the difference between X and Z. This is the crucible plus ash, this is only the crucible. So the difference between X and Z is only the ash content. So the weight of ash is equal to Z minus X. This is the weight of ash. And weight of coal is equal to Y minus X. So the percentage of ash is equal to Z minus X divided by Y minus X into 100. So it is very simple to determine the ash content. Just take the known amount of the dry coal in the crucible, place the crucible in the furnace at around 750 degrees centigrade for half an hour. During this heating, only the ash content remains. That means the residue is the ash. So now take the crucible from the furnace, cool down crucible and take its weight again. And by this formula, we can calculate the ash percentage in the coal sample. Now, percentage of the fixed carbon. To determine the fixed carbon percentage, just subtract the percentage of moisture, volatile matter and ash content from the total 100. So, 100 minus percentage of moisture, volatile matter and the ash content will give the value of the percentage of the fixed carbon. Now, why we determine the moisture, volatile matter, ash and the fixed carbon percentage? Sorry. We all know that the analysis of any type of fuel is to be done only for the quality check purpose. Quality check purpose means how the fuel is useful for heat generation purpose. So, the proximate analysis gives the idea about the quality of the coal sample. First is the percentage of moisture we have determined. The decrease, the presence of the moisture content decreases the calorific value of the coal. And its presence, since its presence decreases the calorific value of the coal, therefore, It decreases the quality of the coal also. Secondly, it increases ignition point of the coal. We know that the ignition point or ignition temperature is the temperature, minimum temperature, which is required to any type of fuel sample to start its burning. If the coal sample contains a large amount of moisture, then its ignition point also increases. So it creates a problem to burn the coal sample. So for a good quality of coal, percentage of moisture should be lower. Second one is the volatile matter. The volatile matter decreases the calorific value of the coal. It elongates flame and decreases flame temperature. It forms smoke and pollutes the air. So in all, the presence of volatile matter decreases the quality of the coal sample. So both of these content, moisture and volatile matter, decreases the quality of the coal sample. Third is the percentage of the ash content. Ash content reduces the calorific value of coal, as ash is non-burning part in the coal. So the amount of ash increases. As the amount of ash increases, the percentage of the fixed carbon decreases. So in indirect way, the presence of ash content decreases the calorific value or the heating value of the coal sample, because its presence reduces the percentage of the carbon. That's why it reduces the calorific value. Secondly, after burning, the ash remains, so its disposal is also a problem. Ash fuses to burn, ash fuses to form clinker at high temperature, obstructing the air supply to coal burning in the furnace. As the coal burns and ash remains, so the remaining, for the combustion of the remaining coal, the oxygen could not supply to this remaining coal, because ash creates a barrier between them. Therefore, lesser the ash percentage, better is the quality of the coal. Last is the fixed carbon. We all know the carbon percentage increases the calorific value of the coal. Carbon is the burning part in the coal, and higher the fixed carbon, higher is the calorific value. Therefore, it increases the quality of the coal. So for better grade coal, always the fixed carbon percentage should be higher side. So it is the time to learning check. Read out the question, pause the video and think about the correct option. Which one is the better quality of coal? Read out these percentages. Yes, you all are right. Correct option is the D option, because in the D option, the fixed carbon percentage is maximum, moisture content is the minimum. And we have just now discussed that for a good quality of coal, fixed carbon percentage should be high, and moisture content, volatile matter and ash content should be low. That's why the option D is the correct option. So what we have learned today? Today we have discussed about the proximate analysis, in which we have learned the determination of percentage of moisture content, volatile matter content and ash, and the fixed carbon content in the given coal sample, and the significance of all these with respect to the quality of the coal sample. That's all for the today's class. Thank you. Take good care of yourself and keep enjoy e-learning at home. Thank you.